Welcome, space scientists and engineers.
Beginning mission.
Design stabilizing fins.
Mission prep time, 15 minutes. Mission duration, 60 minutes. Good luck.
Mission briefing will commence in 3, 2, 1.
NASA's Space Launch System, or SLS, will be the most powerful rocket NASA has ever built. It will enable astronauts to begin their journey to explore destinations far into the solar system. Your mission is to design stabilizing fins for a foam rocket.
Rocket stability is an important issue for rocket engineers. All rocket components are tested in a variety of ways before they are verified for flight. The nose, body, and fins of a rocket are designed to minimize drag and provide stability and control. Rocket fin shapes vary. They can be triangular, rectangular, elliptical, and trapezoidal, to name a few. The fin shape contributes to the rocket's center of mass and how much drag it faces during flight.
To begin, you will need 30-centimeter piece of polyethylene foam pipe insulation, foam food trays, cardboard, or stiff poster board, a long tape measure or rolling measure wheel, a launcher quadrant template printed on cardstock, a thick rubber band, safety glasses, duct tape, scissors, a meter stick, masking tape, one binder clip, one push pin, and string. We will demonstrate a simple version of the foam rocket. If you'd like a slightly more complicated version, please check out DIY Build a Foam Rocket. First, cut a piece 30 centimeters in length of foam pipe insulation. Next, cut 4 equally spaced slits at one end of the tube. The slits should be about 12 centimeters long. This is where your fins will be mounted. Cut a 12 centimeter length piece of duct tape right down the middle into 2 pieces. Place one piece over the other, sticky side to shiny side, to make the tape nice and strong. Now, slip a rubber band over the tape and press the tape around the nose end of the rocket, on the end opposite to where you made the slits. Press it tightly and reinforce it with another length of tape wrapped around the tube. Cut fin pairs from the foam food tray or stiff cardboard. Both fin pairs should be notched so that they can be slid together. Different fin shapes can be used, but they should still nest together. Lastly, slide the nested fins into the slits cut into the tube, and close off the slits with a piece of duct tape wrapped around the end of the foam tube. Now your rocket is finished. Now it's time to begin building the launcher. Start off by cutting the pattern out and fold it on the dashed line. Then, tape the quadrant to the meter stick so that the black dot lies directly over the 60 centimeter mark on the stick. Press a push pin into the black dot. Tie a string to the push pin and hang the binder clip on the end of the string. The binder clip, or weight, should swing freely. Now your launcher is ready to use. Note that the meter stick is upside down when taping the quadrant to the meter stick. Now it's time to test your rocket. Be sure to choose a large open area that is safe to test the rocket in, and safety glasses are a must during launch. Put a piece of string or tape on the ground in a straight line directly in front of the launcher. This line will be used to measure the distance the rocket flew from the launcher and how far off course the rocket traveled. Have the end of the meter stick touching the ground, and then determine which angle you will launch your rocket at and set the meter stick at that angle. Launch at least 3 times at each angle. Remember, do not point the rocket at anyone during launch or areas where people may walk or drive by. After the launch, participants will record the distance the rocket traveled and how far off course the rocket went. After testing your rocket, it's time to make adjustments and improvements, just like engineers here at NASA. First, redesign and build another set of fins. Consider the stability and trajectory of your first set of launches, and think of what improvements could be made to your fin design. Discuss different variables that may impact your results, including the elasticity of the rubber band. Remember, your goal is to increase the stability of your rocket, which is measured by how close it lands near the tape without a significant decrease in how far the rocket traveled from the launch site. Once you've redesigned your fins, test at least 3 more times at the same angle and then compare the results of your redesigned fins with the results of your original design at that same angle. You can take this activity a step further by completing any of the extension options found in the activity guide.
Before you finish, be sure to discuss and answer the following questions. How does a rocket's stability affect trajectory? Why was it important to launch from different angles? How do you think size, shape, weight, or location of fins on a rocket can affect its stability?
Good luck, space scientists and engineers. And remember, all of this is classified.